hear the word development, what comes to your mind? That is why we're here today on another interesting episode of WIN, What is New Platform. It promises to be an insightful moment on education, which is key to humans. We'll be right back. I'm your host, Christopher Morris.
What is new on WIN TV. Keep right on watching.
Hello Nigeria, this is Augusta Marimo. I'm giving a thumbs up for WIN TV. With WIN TV, you can only win, and it's a win-win situation.
If you educate a child, you educate the nation. And that is why today, all the way from Ghana, we have veterans that are here to share the roadmap with us on how people can come from different parts of the continent of Africa to learn in Ghana, the home of gold. On that note, we have veterans from University for Development Studies. And from my right, I have the honor and privilege of meeting. Sir, can we meet you?
Thank you very much. My name is Dr. Elkanah Oyetunji, the Director of Academy for the Quality Assurance Institute.
You're welcome, sir. And from my left, sir.
I am Dr. ABK Zakaria, Acton Registrar of the University for Development Studies.
You're welcome, sir. It's a very unique experience that we're having today. Understand that Ghana is more like a brother and a sister to Nigeria. And today you're here to share a roadmap in education with us. So I would like to hear University for Development Studies. Let's have a background.
University for Development Studies was established by law, PNDC Law 279, and that was in May 1992. That's 20 years ago.
20 years?
Yes. And the university started academic work actually in September 1993. That is 19 years ago. Since then, we have consistently developed our academic programs in line with the mandate given to the university. Right now, we have academic programs spread over four campuses in Northern Ghana. And we have a total population of 21,200 or so students.
Wow, this is very interesting. Okay, now, sir, we'll be looking at it from this other end now. Haven't heard about the year of establishment. I would like us to have the vision of this institution, understanding that the continent of Africa is very big, and we have people coming from different countries as ambassadors of their countries in Ghana to study in university for development studies. Let's have the vision.
Thank you very much. The vision of the University for Development Studies is a home of world-class pro-poor scholarship. This is reflected in its motto, knowledge for service, as well as methodologies of teaching, research, and outreach program.
Sir, let's look at it from your end. University for Development Studies. Let's share some of the uniqueness of this university.
Thank you very much. UDS, by its vision and then its mission, aspects of this were read out by my colleague Dr. Wade. We try to, as much as possible, very close to the communities, blending academic training with practical work in the communities, trying to identify problems within the communities and find solutions together with the rural people to these problems within the communities. That is our emphasis and our trust.
Well, sir, I would like to still move a little bit further. We understand how people go to tertiary institutions, and when they come out, we see people carrying files about. We would like to know, what are the empowering moments that one can actually derive from being a student of University for Development Studies, Ghana?
UDS, apart from the general training that we give to university students Ghana, in Africa, and many other places, that is training them to provide the necessary manpower for the development of their respective countries and communities. UDS is right into this area, but we have, as you said, a unique kind of training that goes beyond this. We try to give our students the kind of training that will first make them very close to rural communities, ready and willing to work in rural communities. We shall talk about that in detail when we come to a special program that we have, a unique program we have, that is a third trimester field practical training. It enables us to train our students and make them get close to rural communities, willing to work with the rural communities. Apart from that, the training we give our students is such that they can be self-employed. And a number of our students who have completed have demonstrated clearly that they are doing very well in self-employment.
Right. Thank you, sir. And that is why I will switch it over to Dr. Ichinji. So I would like to do a little bit of filling the blanks now. Unique selling point of this institution that is bringing people from all around the continent to the same spot. There is convergence of knowledge and the like. So we'd like to hear.
Thank you very much. The registrar of the university has said, one of the unique features of the University for Development Studies is our program that we call 10th Trimester Field Practical Program, TT, with the acronym TTFP. This program, the university runs a trimester system. The first two trimesters are for teaching, which is like the other conventional university. The first trimester and the second trimester. The third trimester is solely devoted to field practicals. During this trimester, students are not in the classroom. Students are sent to the various communities within Ghana to spend the entire trimester of about 12 weeks with the community. They live with the community, they understudy the community, they observe the problems and the potentials of the community with a view to provide solutions to the challenges facing the community. So this is an aspect of the program that actually allow them to practicalize all that they have been taught within the classroom to the benefit of mankind.
Hello, Birds. If you're ready to take the lead in the business world, join us come July 2012 as the eMeet Worldwide from the United States of America in association with Covenant Business Keepers Network and Nigeria International Franchise Association presents National Business Forum 2012. Come, let's share experience with veterans and know why most businesses fail. Learn and explore the seven centers of management attention and learn why investors and banks run after franchise firms. The National Business Forum is targeted at business leaders, entrepreneurs and investors, trade and investment promoters including specialists from public agencies, bankers and financial stakeholders involved in business development and franchising. Date is 23rd and 24th July 2012 by 10 a.m. at the Muson Center, Unicorn, Lagos. The participation fee is 65,000 Naira only, covering e-meet business development materials, certificate of attendance, refreshment and lunch breaks. Register online by logging on to www.emeetnigeriaseminars.com.ng or call Yinka on 0802-322-3736. National Business Forum 2012 is proudly supported by U.S. Consulate, Nigerian Television Authority and Win TV. Come and take the lead in the business world. Be there.
Right, I'll be switching over to the registrar. So, let's look at the programs. It is pertinent to state it here. The programs in this institution, let's have an overview of
them. Before I talk about the programs, I just want to add that UDS is the only university in Ghana that has a structured third trimester practical program. A practical program or a practical approach to teaching and learning that is compulsory to all our students. Every student in UDS, for the first 2 years of their studies in UDS, must do the third trimester practical program. It's part of the training we give them, and it's part of the scoring and the grading that we give to the students. So people who want to have experience, and people who want their awards to have experience and practical training, in whatever subject they will offer in UDS, please send them to UDS and they will be trained both to have academic, very high quality academic training and very high quality practical knowledge in whatever they are doing. The programs we run, we started first with the Faculty of Agriculture, and that is only one faculty. And today, as I speak, we have 8 faculties. 8 faculties that offer various programs. I will talk about 2 of our campuses, the faculties that we have on those campuses. And I think my colleague will name and give you details about the other campuses. I'll mention all the 4 campuses for now. We have the Tamale campus located in the capital, the Northern Regional Capital, which is Tamale. Then we have the Nyankala campus, which is located quite close to Tamale, about some 16 kilometers away from Tamale. We have also the Navongo campus, a distance of over 160 kilometers from the central part of the university, or the headquarters of the university. And this campus, as I said, is called Navongo campus. And finally, we have a campus at another town called Wa in the Upper West Region, which is over 200 kilometers from the central or from the headquarters of the university in Tamale. Now, I would like to say that for the Tamale campus, where we have the central administration, we have a school called the School of Medicine and Health Sciences. Under the School of Medicine and Health Sciences, we provide courses in relation to medicine and health. We have a 7-year program that leads to the award-winning degree MBCHB, and that is medical program. In other words, we train doctors within 7 years. That is at the Tamale campus. We also have a degree in nursing, that is a Bachelor of Science degree in nursing, also on the same Tamale campus, and a Bachelor of Science degree in community nutrition on the Tamale campus. We also have a variant of the BSc nursing program, and that is called a nurse practitioner program. It's a nursing program, and the emphasis is a bit different. As the name would suggest, we have designed the program for those who are already practicing nurses, and then to allow them to come to UDS to get that feel of community relations. And they come in with their diploma certificates to top up for the BSc nurse practitioner program. We have just started for this academic year a program called BSc Nurse Anesthesia. We have advertised, and we are getting very good response from the general public. That program will be started in September this year.
But let's look at the other side of the programs we have. We'd like to hear.
Thank you very much. At the Navongo campus of the University for Diplomatic Studies, we have 2 faculties there. We have the Faculty of Mathematical Sciences, and I should underscore the fact that this is one of the very few universities that have devoted the whole faculty to the study of mathematics. This is unique, again, to UDS. Under this faculty, we have a whole lot of programs there. We have computer science, we have actuarial science, we have financial mathematics, we have statistics, we have mathematics with economics, and then we have a new program which, again, we are just starting come September this year. This is BSc Information Technology. The second faculty on the campus, Navongo campus, is the Faculty of Applied Sciences. And we have a whole lot of program there too. We have program leading to the award of BSc Applied Biology. We have program leading to the award of BSc Applied Chemistry, BSc Applied Physics, BSc Environmental Science, and BSc Biochemistry. The 4th campus of the universities is at the Upper West region of Ghana, and this is called the Wa campus of the university. There are 3 faculties in this on this campus. We have the Faculty of Integrated Development Studies. This faculty do programs in the Integrated Development Studies. This gives our students opportunity. The campus is art-based campus, And the integrated development studies gives students the opportunity to have a broad-based understanding on art-related subjects. It's usual in recent days, institutions try to specialize students early enough. Thereby, students have limited scope. And so when they want to go for postgraduate studies, they are limited to the range of options they can do there. But our students under the Faculty of Integrated Development Studies, they are given an integrated nature of a study that gives them a good background in anything they want to go and do after their first degree. We also have the Faculty of Planning and Land Management. This faculty has programs in real estate, land management, and a whole lot of programs there. Then we have the third faculty, Faculty of Education, Law, and Business Studies. We have a lot of business program related programs. We have business in accounting, business in commerce, programs in commerce, programs in accounting, programs in education under this faculty.
So, understanding that studying outside your country, as in having an education from the diaspora, comes with a lot of benefits. Now, we have parents watching that actually want to engage their kids in this university for development studies. We would like to share it from your end. What are the security nature of the institution?
Thank you very much, the presenter. There are a lot of advantages for prospective students who want to study, who want to come to the U.S. to pursue their academic career. One, there is security. We have well-trained security personnel, apart from the state security personnel. Within all our campuses, we have well-trained security personnel that ensure that security lives and properties on campus are secured. In addition to that, we have another unique advantage of the university is that we have a serene environment, an environment that students and their parents will be happy when they come. We also have a stable academic calendar. Our four-year program is our four-year program. You can predict when the student is coming in this year, you can predict. If it's coming for a four-year program or a seven-year program, like you registered mentioned the other time, for those who are studying medicine.
That's it, yeah.
So you can be sure that at the end of 4 years or 7 years, you will graduate from the program that you registered. And there's high level of discipline among our students. Students, they interact very well with the lecturer. We have very good academic staff that are constantly in touch with the students. We have all tutors, we have all the department. The way we are structured, they are such that anytime any student have any issue, they can easily walk into the head of department office, interact with the head of department, the head of department will take care of whatever challenges.
All right. Hello there, my name is Kamal Salau. I'm the Nigerian host of Don't Forget the Lyrics and also the general manager at City 105.1 FM, and you're watching What's New on Win TV.
Watching What Is New on Win TV. Keep right on watching.
Hello Nigeria, this is Augusta Maribola giving a thumbs up for Win TV. With Win TV, you can only win, and it's a win-win situation.
It has actually been an insightful moment with veterans in education from University for Development Studies, Ghana, the land of gold, permit me to say that. And I want to believe you've been getting adequate information and how you can actually tap into this opportunity being created for us to be part of the whole process there in the institution. And now we're looking at the admission process. I know you've been waiting for this, but don't forget that you can still go on to our YouTube channel to play back this interview, and the website is there, www.uds.edu.gh, to actually make inquiries and find out how it's been. But for now, let's look at the admission processes. Sir, we would like you to share this with us.
Our admission process for both Ghanaian and Nigerian students is not too different at all. The difference is just that in Ghana we have what we call integrated science, which is one of the core subjects you must pass before you enter university. So what we notice is that Nigerian students do not write this paper at the Western Class Research Exam. They don't write interpreted science. So we simply substitute a science subject for the integrated science. So you need to have three core subjects: English, mathematics, and any science subject. As a Nigerian, you need these three. Then you also need three elective subjects with a combined aggregate of not more than 36. 36 here means that with the West African School Certificate Examinations grading, the minimum that you can have is a credit of C6. That's what we accept. We don't accept D7, E8, or F9. So if you have, for example, C6 in all your six subjects, three core and then three electives, you qualify to be admitted to UDS. But each subject has its own cutoff point. There are certain programs that you need very good aggregate to enter. For example, medicine. If you want to be a doctor in UDS, we expect that you just don't apply with C6. If you have a very good aggregate, a combination of A plus, is it A1, and then some B, maybe B2, a combination of them, then you can qualify to do our medical program. Other programs are less competitive, for example, nursing, our applied faculty programs, our agricultural programs. You may not need to have just A1 and B2. Maybe some number of C's and then C4 and B3 and so on, you can qualify to come. So we would wish that students can inquire from us. They will give them the details. But apart from West African School Certificate Examination candidates, we also admit higher national diploma candidates. They will come for interview, and when they pass the interviews, they will not start from the first year. They will start from the second year to do degree programs. But they must have a minimum of a second class upper in their programs. We also accept diploma holders, national diploma holders, whether from universities or any accredited institutions in Nigeria. Those who have diploma in nursing can also apply to do BSc nursing in our university. Here again, they should have very good class, very good performance in the diploma program. These are our initial requirements.
All right, so thank you. Before I switch over to the director, Quality Assurance Unit, I would like you to share, UDS is located in Ghana, and you are here in Nigeria, inviting us. Who is anybody representing UDS here in Nigeria?
Yes, we have a representative in Nigeria, the Director General of King's Crown Business School in Lagos. The details, you see that on the screen. Can contact him for further details and further explanations, further information about UDS. For those who also want to send emails directly to UDS, you can do that, and the email address is right on your screens. You can contact us directly or through the Director General, King's Crown Business School.
Right, thank you very much. And before we go, I would like to take it from the end of the Director, I like calling that the Director Quality Assurance Unit. Is that right?
Yes.
That's pretty important. Dr. Yetunde, please share with us more words from what you just did now.
Well, in addition to what the Registrar just said about our admission requirement, I think I also like to underscore the fact that the student coming from Nigeria do not need to write JAMB.
Wow.
There is also no need to write a post-JAMB. Okay, so once you meet the admission requirement and you apply online, you'll be given admission, and the admission letter will be sent to you.
Here at Civic Center today for G Nigeria, courtesy Google, the world's largest search engine. And with me is Tone Koka and Lola Masha. I would like to get it from you quickly.
G Nigeria is our annual flagship event where we celebrate our partners. We celebrate partnerships across developers, telco partners, and entrepreneurs. We're very excited to be here, and we look forward to strengthening our relationships with all our various stakeholders. And we're also glad that you're here with us to share the excitement.
So quickly, what do you feel about this experience today?
Well, it's very inspiring, and it's actually a great one to see a lot of developers and business people come together to share Google technology and products.
Right. Okay. Now back to Lola Masha. Let her just give us 30 seconds of what Google SMS is all about. A wrap up.
The one exciting thing that we are launching today at this event is our Google SMS chat, which allows users to send SMS messages, hey, for free from your Gmail account. Google is trying to put cash in your pocket by launching and rolling out products and services that leverages technology to make your life a lot easier. So please try it out. Go to www.gmail.com and sign up now.
All right.